So you want to know the best way to play with the French club Paris Saint-Germain? Well, that's great, because in this video I'm going to show you how you can get the best out of this team, in my opinion, of course. I'm going to show you the formation, the lineup, tactics and the instructions, just like in the first video that I made about this team, because this is the second video that I'm making, but this one would be very more detailed, because I'm going to show you a full set of game plans as well. So five different tactics that you can use during a match in different scenarios. But before I begin, I really wanted to ask you to drop a like under the video. It will be really helpful for me and my channel to grow, to rank my videos higher on YouTube. So small favor I'm asking, I think, please smash that like button for me. And if you're new to the channel, I want to find your way back really easy. I'm doing lots of team reviews like this for all other teams. I'm doing tutorial videos and also Ultimate Team. So if you don't want to miss anything, make sure you are subscribed with notifications on. All right, you see me here playing in a season match against Manchester City, and we are scoring this penalty kick with Neymar, fifth goal, and my opponent is going to leave. So that was a great result, and I'm going to show you now how I did that. We're starting with the formation. It's a different formation than in the first video. This is the 4-3-2-1 formation. The lineup that I use is Donnarumma as the goalkeeper, Hakimi right, Marquinhos and Kimpembe are the center backs, Mendes the left defender. I'm using Sanchez in the middle, set at the right side of the central midfield, Verratti the central one, because he's the most defensive player. I'm going to show you that later in the instructions. And this guy, his name is changed to Ruiz. How he was called before, Fabian, I think. Yes, it was Fabian. He is still in the team, but yeah, his name is changed. 85 rated central mid on the left side. And then we're using as a central forward on the right side, Messi, the striker is Mbappe, and on the left side we have Neymar. Now we're going to the tactics for this one. This is just the starter formation from the beginning of the match. Defensive style balanced, the width 45, the depth 50, build up play balanced, direct passing on chance creation, the width is 50, plays in the box, four bars, corners and free kicks, both two bars. And what I said, this is just the beginning formation. So you're starting with this one, just checking out your opponent, how he is playing. So not going all the way attacking just from the beginning, or just really defensive, just a bit balanced formation, and check out how your opponent is playing. That is why we are making this one. Stay back while attacking on the instruction for Hakimi. Marquinhos, Kimpembe are just default, and Mendes also stay back while attacking. Then we have Sanchez. He has the high eye work rates, and yeah, he's going to play like a box-to-box player. So everything on him is just default. I already said Verratti is playing the most defensive, so stay back while attacking. Stay on the edge of the box for the cross and cover center for him. Why cover center? I'm getting these questions a lot. Why do you use cover center? Sometimes yes, sometimes no. In this case, I'm using cover center because I want Verratti to defend this. And Sanchez is on cover wing. Ruiz is on cover wing. So when it's necessary, Sanchez will go that way. You don't want Verratti also to go that way. The same for the left side, of course. You already have this guy and this guy, so you don't want Verratti to go to the side as well. So that's why I'm using him on cover wing in this case. Ruiz also playing more like a box-to-box player. His work rates are different than Sanchez, but just default, no instructions on him. Then we have Messi on the right side. Only thing I changed is stay forward. Then we have Mbappe, get in behind and stay forward. And then we have Neymar, also only stay forward, just like Messi. All right, this is just the starter formation. Now we are going to the attacking formation. And this one is when I'm using when I think, well, the game is going good. My opponent, 9 out of 10 times he's just a bit even like I am, because we are in the same division, of course. But I really want to put a bit pressure on him, and I feel that I can score goals. We are just even, but if I'm just putting a bit more pressure, a bit more attacking football, then I'm able to score some goals. That is the scenario when you want to try this one. It's the same formation, same lineup, so don't change anything on that. The only thing that we are changing a bit is the tactic. So the instructions are also the same, only the tactics are different. Defensive style is on press after possession loss. So when you are losing the ball, your players are going to try to get the ball back as soon as possible, and hopefully your opponent is struggling with that and he's losing the ball, so you can set up a quick attack. So the width is a bit the same. The depth is higher on the pitch with 60, so your whole team is going to move forward higher on the pitch because of the pressure football that's really necessary. Then the build-up play, I'm also using long ball because players are going to make some more runs with this than balanced. So when you have the ball after the press, after possession loss, when you recover the ball, when you get it back, the players will make runs immediately, and hopefully you can give a through ball and create some chances with that. The chance creation is still on direct passing. The width is on 50. Plays in the box a bit more, just 6 bars. And corners and free kicks are just the same, both 2 bars. As I already said, instructions are exactly the same as in the first one. All right, then we're going to the ultra attacking formation. And this one is you are going to choose when you are behind, where your opponent is leading, and you really need to score goals. Or when you think, well, I'm so much better than my opponent, I really need to score some goals now, then you can go to this one, because this is ultra, ultra attacking. So this is the formation. It's the 3-4-1-2 formation. Donnarumma is the goalkeeper, Marquinhos center back, Kimpembe center back, and Ruiz is on this case also a center back, but I would recommend to switch him, to substitute him for Ramos, because you don't want Ruiz as a center back, of course, so you need to make a substitute when you are going to change to this formation. Let's go to the right side. Hakimi on the right side, of course. Sanchez, Verratti are the central midfielders, and Mendes is on the left side. Messi is the attacking midfielder, and Mbappe and Neymar are the strikers. Then we're going to the tactics. Press after possession loss, a bit wider than the attacking formation. 50 on the width, higher on the pitch, because you want some pressure, you feel you are way much better than your opponent, so, or you just need to score goals and you need to take some more risk, of course. So we're putting the depth on 75, really high on the pitch. Long ball on build up, direct passing, chance creation, the width 45, plays in the box 7 bars, so a bit more than the 6 bars on the attacking one. Corners or free kicks on 3 bars, because you really want to score goals, so a bit more players in the box. But keep in mind that if you have this on 3 bars, that you are really weak on the counter attack, where you don't win the ball during a corner or a free kick. So keep in mind that your opponent can score easy goal with a good counter attack. All right, then we're going to the instructions. All the center backs are just default. I didn't change anything. Then we have Sanchez. Only thing I changed for him is cover center. And why is that? I'm going to explain that, because Hakimi is going back. I'm going to show that later in the instructions. And when he is not back in time, I don't want Sanchez to go that way. And why is that? Because the right center back is going to go to the right side as well. So then you have Sanchez and Marquinhos going to the right side, and then you have a really wide gap here in this space. And that's not what I want with this formation. So Sanchez just going back in the middle, and Hakimi, when he is back in time, there is no problem, and else Marquinhos will go to the right side, and then you have 2 center backs as well in the center, so that would be enough 9 out of 10 times. All right, then we go to Verratti, the same instructions on the cover center, but the other one, let's go back a bit, it was a bit too fast, sorry for that. Verratti, let's go to Verratti. Yes, there he is. Stay back while attacking and stay on the edge of the box for the cross and cover center. So he's playing a bit more defensive than Sanchez, also in this formation. Then we have Hakimi, come back on defense and stay wide, are the only 2 things I changed for him. The same for Mendes, come back on defense and stay wide. All other things default. Then we have Messi, stay forward on this one. Mbappe, get in behind, stay forward. Neymar, get in behind and stay forward. And having these 3 players on stay forward in all the formations that we have, that is because I really like to have 3 players in front. When you recover the ball, you can pass the ball forward, and almost every time there is someone available for the pass. And these 3 attackers are the only attackers that are really good in this squad. You have no one on the bench, no attacker on the bench, that is just similar to these guys, or just a bit less quality. They are so worse. All other attackers in this formation, even Sarabia, is not even usable as a substitute. So I don't want my attackers to become tired with defending, so that's why I keep them on a stay forward in all the attacking formations. All right, then we're going to the 4-1-2-1-2 formation. This one is when I think the 4-3-2-1 formation that we are using from the beginning is not working. Sometimes you have that you think, well, it's really hard to set up an attack with this formation, and then you switch to the more attacking formation, and maybe that is not even working. Then you switch to a way different formation than the other one, and that's why I'm using this defending formation. It's not really more defending than the other one, it's just a different formation to switch in game when your formation is not working. So this one is the 4-1-2-1-2 small formation, the narrow formation, I need to say. The lineup is the same: Donnarumma, Hakimi, Marquinhos, Kimbembe, Mendes. Verratti is playing as central defensive midfielder. Sanchez and Ruiz are the central midfielders. Messi attacking midfielder. Mbappe and Neymar are the strikers. Then we're going to the tactics, just balanced like the first formation. The width is 40, depth is 45. The build-up play also balanced. Chance creation is direct passing. The width is 50. Plays in the box, 5 bars. Corners and free kicks, both 2 bars. And then we're going to the instructions. Hakimi, stay back while attacking. Marquinhos and Kimbembe default. And Mendes, stay back while attacking. Then we're going to Verratti. Verratti, cut passing lanes and stay back while attacking. And also cover center, the same. Like the first formation, we have Ruiz and Sanchez, both are on cover wing, so when it's necessary they are going wide, and you want Verratti in the middle, else there are two people going wide and then you have a wide gap in the middle of your defense, and that's not what you want. Then we're going to the central midfielders. Let's go to Sanchez first. He is just default. I didn't change anything. The same for Ruiz. Just default. Didn't change anything. And then Messi again. Stay forward because we don't want him to get tired from defending. Mbappe, get in behind. Stay forward. And the same for Neymar. Get in behind and stay forward. All right. Then we're going to the last formation. And this one is when you are leading and you are under heavy pressure and you feel like, I really need to change something, else I'm gonna consider some goals, even losing the match. So then you are going to play ultra defensive, of course, because you don't want any goals against. And this is the formation that we are using. It's the 5-2-3 formation. Donnarumma is the goalkeeper and Hakimi on the right side. Marquinhos, Ruiz and Kimbembe are center backs, but again, replace Ruiz for this guy, for Ramos. Use him as a substitute. And then you have 3 really good center backs. That's what you want, of course. And Ruiz is out. Kimbembe and Mendes on the left side. Then we have Sanchez and Verratti as the central midfielders. Messi on the right side. Mbappe as a striker. And Neymar on the left side. All right. Then we're going to the tactics. I choose drop back because you want everybody to come back to defend and help the defense out, so you don't get any goals against. The width is 40. The depth is also 40. I would not go lower than 35 on this, because else your whole defense will be lined up like there, and your center or midfielders are just there. There are only 2, and then it's really easy for your opponent to shoot from distance like here. And when he is good at shooting from distance, we all know that you can score some really, really good goals from distance. So that's not what you want. So on 40, your defense will be lined up here, so when he wants to shoot, you have 5 defenders to block the ball. Then we're going to the build-up play. I use slow build-up. What that is doing is your players, when you have the ball, will make themselves available for passing. And when you have the ball in this situation, you are leading and you don't want to consider any goals, you don't want to go fast for fast attacks, because 9 out of 10 times you have really much players in the defense, there is no option to play the ball forward, and you lose the ball again, and then you need to defend again. So you want really lots of options to pass the ball around, and slow build-up can do that. Just watch for the player that is free, pass the ball around, keep your ball in your own squad, just pass it around, and hopefully you can sit out your time until the 90th minute, till the full match is over. The chance creation is unbalanced, the width is 50, plays in the box, 4 bars, corners or free kicks, both 1 bar. And then we're going to the instructions. Hakimi, stay back while attacking, and I have him on overlap. Sometimes when you have the ball and there is a really wide gap on the right side, then you want Hakimi to go forward to make himself available. You can do that by trigger him to make a run with the R1 button, and then you want him to make an overlap run. You want him to stay on the side of the field, not going inside, because it's already really crowded there with 3 center backs, 2 central midfielders. So you want him to stay on the side of the field, make himself available, keep the field really wide so you have some options to pass the ball around if everybody is narrow to each other. It's way harder to pass the ball around, so that's why I have him on overlap. Then we're going to the center backs, all 3 just default, and Mendes the same as Hakimi, stay back while attacking and overlap run type. Then both central midfielders, stay back while attacking, stay on the edge of the box for the cross and cover center. The same for Verratti, stay back while attacking, stay on the edge of the box for the cross, cover center. So both central midfielders will defend the middle. No cover wing, because we already have Hakimi here, we already have Mendes here, and even Messi is coming back and Neymar is coming back. I'm going to show you that later. So you don't want them to cover the wing. So cover center is really important in this one. Messi, on all formations, we have him on stay forward, but when you really want to defend your lead, then he needs to come back as well to help the defense out. That's what this formation is about. So come back on defense. Oh, this one is not good. This one needs to be on normal. I don't know if it's really different, but just normal. The same for Neymar. Come back on defense. And then we have Mbappe. He is the only player that is staying forward with drift wide, with the get in behind. And as you can see, stay forward. What that will do is at least you will have 2 center backs of your opponent with him. So not the center backs are going forward also. So always 2, maybe 3 players of your opponent will stay with him to cover him. And when you have the ball with the drift wide, he is trying to make some runs into the free space. And with the pace that he has, 9 out of 10 times he's faster than the center back. Well, maybe 10 out of 10 times. And if you have him on just cover, on stay central, then he is here against 2 center backs, 9 out of 10 times. Some people are just even with 3 center backs. So you want him to make some runs into the free space. And when there is an opportunity to go right, you want him to go right. Or when there is an opportunity to go left, you want him to go left. You give him a long ball, a high through ball, I don't care, but he will get the ball. And you have some time to get some breathe again from your opponent, pass the ball around. When he has the ball, you can play it back to Neymar, play it back to Messi, or when you are really lucky, you can go one-on-one on the goalkeeper when he's making a run. If it's a good ball, then you can go one-on-one on the goalkeeper and score even some goals. So that is what you want, of course. Well, this is it for all the formations and the tactics and stuff. Hopefully all is clear. If you have some questions, you can drop it in the comments, of course, then I'll try to answer them. And then we are going to the substitutes that I'm using the most. Well, I already said it, Ramos, you can bring him in for Ruiz when you need to play with 3 defenders or with 5 defenders. Then we're using Vitinha 9 out of 10 times. I'm replacing him for Ruiz when I'm just playing the 4-3-2-1 or the 4-1-2-1-2. Ruiz will get tired and I will replace him for Vitinha. What you also can do is bringing Soler for Sanchez, because Sanchez will also getting some tired. As I already said, I don't have any replacements for the attackers because, yeah, Sarabia is not that good and all the other players are even worse, so that's not what you want. And sometimes, yeah, you can bring in Pereira or Mukili or Bernat. It depends a bit on how the game goes. But 9 out of 10 times, I replaced Soler for Sanchez and Vitinha for Ruiz. All right, this is it for this formation for Paris Saint-Germain. It was a bit long video, but it's more detailed and hopefully it will help you to get more wins. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day, people. Bye-bye.